4. Payments in cryptocurrencies. Cryptocurrencies holders prefer to pay in crypto rather than having to change in cumbersome traditional fiat currency. Today, a very small part of our potential customers do have cryptocurrency, but this percentage is likely to rise in the future. It is therefore possible that in a few years, the platforms offering the possibility of paying cryptocurrency will have an edge, at least for a certain initial period. Let's say that Facebook does this Libra thing, even if we can consider it not a real cryptocurrency, they will make people get used to wallets rather than credit cards. And that probably will speed up the adoption of cryptocurrencies. Having said that, this will bring customers in the short term, but it's very easy for any OTA to accept cryptocurrencies when they get more widespread. So it's like a short-term advantage over OTAs. It won't be an advantage in the long term. It's going to be an advantage with TRIPS tokens, and that is for the next point. So if you have TRIPS tokens, which you have earned by helping TRIPS, by uploading an apartment, by getting bookings, then you will be able to spend them and book. So this is not going to be possible on the OTAs. 5, tokenization. Well, we haven't invented tokenization. That's a concept which emerged from the cryptocurrency world and has been adopted by many companies. It's still in its very early stages, but let's read it. A guest who books with a traditional portal for several years does not have great advantages in the future use of the same portals, with the exception of classic loyalty strategies such as the Genius of Booking.com that reserves dedicated discounts to some users. In the same way, the first Airbnb customers have not been rewarded for their strategic role as early adopters. On the other hand, a guest who uses TRIPS will receive a portion of the commission in the form of TRIPS, becoming immediately part of the network. From that moment onwards, the guest will have an economic incentive and a direct interest in the success of the platform, a reason to push up the token value. In the event that the token price increases, the guest can also book other accommodations at a fraction of the cost. If, for example, the guest receives an equivalent value of $100 in TRIPS, and after 6 months the TRIPS price doubles, she can book an accommodation worth $200 with the same number of tokens. In TRIPS, early adopters will acquire significant wealth when the token gets price and liquidity. The idea is this. The first hosts of Airbnb in New York, the first 100 hosts were very important for Airbnb to take off. Today, they are making less money than they used to make. They have not been invited to the party because the structure is investor, founders, employee. The hosts are not part of the company. They are just there. They got their bookings and they should be happy with that. In TRIPS, the platform users are part of the party. So if this becomes a success, you have earned those tokens and they will have a value. So it's effectively a way to make everybody aligned on the same idea, and everybody having those tokens will try to make those tokens more expensive, so they will try to make the platform successful. It's simply, in theory at least, a better way to deal with platforms. It's like saying traditional companies, traditional corporations are great for many kind of companies. They are not great for platforms because they forget about the users of those platforms. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, or share. You can comment in YouTube, LinkedIn, or directly in the Google Docs white paper page. Thank you for watching.